everything's great, so I guess we might as well get
Yeah.
started. So, welcome to Code Channel, I'm Code, and we're going to be playing Dark Souls 2, Scholars of the First Sin, and I'm here with my good friend, Tristan!
Hey, hey! This is Tristan, again.
Yes, yes. One of the people that I think is probably, that I know that is, like, most knowledgeable about Dark Souls 2.
Incredibly.
Yes,
overly,
incredibly.
Overly knowledgeable, honestly.
You know,
unfortunately knowledgeable about this game.
It's like a knowledge you've acquired, but it's like it's a gift and a curse.
It's true. I have to use it for good, but it's so hard to use it for good.
Yes, this is a very very specific skill. Hey, Steve. Steve's in the chat.
Hey, Steve.
Okay, using your expert skills, how do we Majula?
Well, first, after loading the game, so that's the wrong thing to do.
Uh-oh.
You need to Alt F. Wait, you're on a PS4. Crap, you can't Alt F4. Never mind.
No, I got this. I think I can Alt F4.
Alright, just take a gun out and shoot the PS4. That's best bet.
Okay. Step one. I think we're... Yes. We're well on our way. We're well on our way to completing New Game Plus.
Alright, great.
So yeah, I guess basically...
We have so many... There's so many bonfires unlocked now.
I know, we're making progress quite quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I want to go to the other bonfire. So I guess, like, to catch people up who might have missed yesterday, we're starting New Game Plus, so New Game Plus, and I have, like, a couple goals here, which is mostly to collect spells and stuff that I missed, or not so much missed as much as the ones that are only available in New Game Plus. Or via using bonfire aesthetic. Did I just warp to the same bonfire? I totally warped to the same bonfire. Crap.
I do that all the time. I was like, I gotta go here again. Wait, I was just here.
So sometimes,
what am I doing?
Sometimes you look at the picture and it's like, particularly in this area, the Bastille, like you look at the picture and it's like, they all look a little bit the same. I know the area
yeah.
I wanted to go to, but they all kind of look similar. But
they all kind of do sometimes too, especially in the Bastille. You're right.
Yeah.
I have a hard time fighting figuring out where to go. Like, if I'm going to go to like Angus's workshop or whatever it is.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was like, is this Angus's workshop of the Exile? I had to read the little bottom. Like, oh, I should be reading this the entire time, like an actual person.
Yeah, I know. The other one was for me was like Straits, like thing. It says right there that you're going to like Straits Cell, and
yeah.
I never read it. I always end up like warping to the one that's like in the middle of the Bastille, the one that I currently don't
mm-hmm.
have, but I'm going to maybe fix that right now. So yeah, the main
goal.
Well,
let's get on it.
Yeah, that's the plan. We're doing it right now. We're gonna fight the pursuer. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, right. That's what we're doing next.
Yeah.
This guy keeps showing up during a bunch of enemies around there. Super cheap, this guy. Super cheap.
Yeah. Don't shoot arrows at me. God. He's gonna run away now.
Shoot more arrows at him.
No. Shoot less arrows.
Keep shooting the arrows at him. No. Good teamwork, guys.
He turned to dust. Whatever.
Keep helping him.
Okay, I'm going to get rid of these guys. Ow. Screw these guys. They're interrupting my... Ow! My cool fight.
Well, that'll happen.
Yeah. I'm going through the, like, initial phase I go through every stream where it's like, oh god, I can't wield my sword. Swinging it.
How do I swing this thing again? Oh,
yeah.
No.
Is this what I've been using? It doesn't feel like it.
Do I use two hands in this? Or
yeah.
One hand? Do I just use the shield the entire time?
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe just two-hand a shield instead.
Oh man, I need two Havel shields. That is going to be my third playthrough.
Well, you have the door shield, right?
Yes, I do.
The crazy like
yeah,
like
I could,
the dozer shield basically.
Yeah, I could use both of them. That'd
yeah,
be
you can
cool.
power stance that stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be really cool actually. Oh shoot! Okay, there was a guy behind me. I guess camera was not being helpful there.
The guy just jumped in out of nowhere and decided he wanted to mess you up.
Yeah. He must have been the one that's behind the wall. I was thinking if I just didn't break the wall, he might not find me.
No.
That never works. That never works in Dark Souls.
Never does, ever. No.
No. Whatever, we're gonna take another run
Basically,
at
if you
the
run past a
pursuer.
point, there's gonna be somebody jumping behind you and getting you,
There's
so.
just gonna be a trail of death behind you whenever you leave enemies behind
Basically.
you. So. But. Yeah, I guess our goal tonight is beat up more bosses, do more of
Okay.
Lugatiel's side quests if possible, more of Benhart's side quests, explode, I guess, and get more spells. Yeah. There's not that many spells in New Game Plus I have to get. I got all the ones that I can get in the first cycle, but yeah.
Yeah, as
Oh
far as I
shit. I
have
didn't know he
seen
had
from what you
projectile.
showed me. Wait, does he? Oh, yeah, he does.
Oh, okay. Interesting. I guess it hasn't really come up that often.
Yeah, no, exactly. He just shoots one little laser beam and he's like, ah, that's good enough. I'm gonna come and mess you up now.
Oh
I got this
god.
big sword, I'm just gonna fuck you up.
Yeah. He doesn't like to cross over this little threshold here.
No.
Yeah.
That's his I
The floor is
it's like
lava
hot
over
lava
there.
for him, basically. Yeah.
He's like, oh, I can't go up that tiny incline. No way.
What are you talking? Oh, that's totally made of lava. I gotta put a cushion on that and jump
Yeah,
across it.
exactly.
So I can put a coffee table there.
Yeah, exactly. Slide the coffee table over. He's literally trying to like cross over on top of a coffee table to get me.
It's got a broom handle.
He's like, I am the pursuer. He's like trying to like poke me with the sword across like the coffee table.
Yeah,
Oh,
exactly.
perfect,
It's
perfect.
actually kind of ironic because he doesn't pursue you too much if you run away from him.
Yeah, no, he doesn't pursue very
Think about
far.
that.
Yeah.
No, he's not very good at it, to be
No,
honest.
he's far better when he had the eagle.
Yes, when
Yeah.
he actually dropped in from the Sweet
Yeah.
Eagle and he's like, "Hey, I'm the pursuer. I'm here to like just ruin all your day."
Yeah.
And then he just went away when you beat him, and he's like, "Well, I guess I'll just kind of
He's like,
pursue
oh
you lackadaisically
man.
now." I kind of lost the luster.
Yeah.
It's just gonna
Oh
cut
god,
to him
where'd
doing
this
like a
guy come
Rocky
from?
training
Whoa.
montage.
Oh god.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah, I thought I took care of him. That's okay.
No, apparently
Huh.
not.
Yeah. Jeez. I guess maybe it was the guy that exploded in the side room there, but he just didn't blow. Yeah, okay, blew up the side room. He definitely blew up the side room. Eh, whatever. Actually,
That is the good thing with having like a big wide swinging sword if you can just like
yeah.
walk in that room and swing once and clear it all
Clear
out.
it out, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. Let me think here. I'm having one of those moments where it's like, I know kind of where I need to go. Yeah. And I don't think this is the direction now that I think about it.
Well, I just walked into a room with a bunch of crossbow wielding guys,
Yeah.
so I don't know. Maybe that's right.
You're like, it's probably right.
close enough.
Close enough.
Is there death in here? Well, it's a kind of a right of direction to go to, so
Yeah.
it's like
Exactly.
whatever.
Whatever.
Yeah.
It's close enough. What do you want?
What
You looking for a
do
boss?
you want from me? Stop judging me, God.
Actually, I do have the two door shields white. I just don't have them both equipped. I could equip both of them, but
You would be a literal
yeah.
like slow as a bulldozer, basically.
Yeah, I'd be a bulldozer. Yeah, you're right.
Yep.
That's
True.
yeah. I gotta think. Okay, I know one way I can go here, but I'm like, maybe I don't want to go that way.
Or do you?
Yeah, so that's the question, I guess.
That is really the question.
Okay, let's give it a shot.
Oh, well.
Gonna do the stupid jump. Actually, cause you know what it is? I need a
Oh, during that
branch.
jump. You do, yes.
Is it
I
in
mean, you
here? Does it
could.
look like? Okay, no, it was just the way the floor was. It looks sealed. Yeah, see, I need a branch to open up the side door. Actually, maybe I should check if I have a branch. That's a good idea.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Check out that right now. I don't think you did get a branch or anything, but
No.
you might as well check it.
Yeah. I checked. I gave up.
No? Okay.
No. I just use humanity too.
Be...
You're supposed to roll that, not jump it. Whatever. I remember the technicality, like, as soon as my feet left the ground, I'm like, that's a roll. Need that forward momentum.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are you gonna do? Yeah, I find actually that one specific door, like trying to get that shortcut.
Yeah.
My last playthrough I was doing this game, I could not get it ever. For some reason, I have no idea why.
Yeah, and it's just how, like, things can be kind of finicky sometimes. Particularly jumps. Mm. Jumps are not the most reliable thing.
Yeah. Oh, actually, speaking of which, you know in Bloodborne...
Woo! I didn't roll far enough.
The area with the... Oh, God. When I go to the area with the Shia Gorath.
Okay.
Like the big old eyeball monster that
right.
Furies you.
Yes.
Causes you fury.
Mind trusts. Brain trusts.
Yeah, that's what it is. Yeah, brain trust. Like the big one.
Yeah.
So I was trying to show my friend and co-host Kenny that.
Right.
And basically, I was trying to show him this cool thing, but like you had to go to the elevator and just jump off into like the little area.
Right.
I could not do that for the life of me at all.
Oh.
Like just like 10 tries. I'm like, oh god, just stay, Kenny. You know, just look at this thing. I'll get to it right now.
You're like,
oh, I'm dead again.
You're like, Kenny, close your eyes. Close your eyes until I do it right. The game is not normally like
this. Just pretend I'm not this bad. Oh god, tell me I'm not bad.
It's always the worst when you're trying to show somebody something and it's like, oh god, I can't do it now. Hey, I got some humanity.
Yeah,
that'll
pretty much.
Make up for that. Oh my god, I want to say brain trusts, but I feel like it's mind trusts. But I think that's the mistake I always
think it is mind trust.
Is it? If you have a computer up, you can check it, I suppose.
I do have a computer.
Okay, let's give this one more shot. If I miss it, this time I'll go for branch. Oh god, that was a bad roll. Eh, whatever, we'll wait for a branch. I know where I can go. Maybe. It's funny, and you know what occurred to me, like, before the stream, while I was thinking about it earlier? I don't remember these areas as well as what I did the world in the first Dark Souls. And it's because you bomb fire so much in this. You're cutting out the middle sections. Like, you might only do, like, a certain section once or twice. And then you have, like, access to the bonfires. So I think that's what's caused that discrepancy.
Yeah, I'd fully agree, actually. Yeah. With the way that the first Dark Souls works, where it, again, loops in on each other, and each level is designed to make sure that you are going up and down, and has so many levels to it, and like the middle area is like so much different from the bottom area, and that kind of thing.
Exactly.
The first game feels like you know it better, just because each little section is so much more different from every other little section.
Right.
Even though it still is thematically the same.
Yeah. No.
Thematically, not thematically.
There you go. Thematically.
I say words.
We got it.
I got it.
I'm gonna go to the forest and do stuff here, because I feel like I know what I'm doing here, maybe?
Sure.
You're like, sure.
I mean, this is the right place to go for...
If I'm gonna find a branch, I'm probably gonna find it in the woods, right? seems like the right place to go.
I mean, you do, like... There are trees around, so I have to assume.
Oh, the branches are all the way up there.
No. Oh, I gotta climb this tree. Shit.
I like this guy. He's just the head in a pile of junk.
Oh, Vengarl? Yeah.
Yeah, Vengarl.
I like Vengarl a lot. He's really cool.
Yeah. It's one of those things that, like, there's so many NPCs in Dark Souls 2, and I have to admit, I kind of...
Mm-hmm.
Initially, it was like... I was like... Hopefully it's going to be, you know, not too many, or it's, you know, hopefully they're going to be fleshed out, but I felt like I found quite a few characters that were quite likable, so, you know, most of the characters feel well fleshed out.
Yeah, I don't think I really hated any of the NPCs in this game.
Yeah.
Like, barring the fact that, like, Lucatiel will just drop off a wharf with the drop of the hat.
Yeah, really. I suppose where in the first one where she didn't have good tracking, probably...
Yeah.
Probably... led to some frustration around her character.
It's a bit of a problem for her, yeah.
Yeah.
Makes her less likable, even though she's kind of the most likable character in the game.
Yeah.
She at least has like the best backstory anyway.
Yeah. No, it was like the gist I got out of her backstory was pretty good. It
Yeah.
was. Yeah. Oh, I didn't know you could buy great swords from him. That's interesting.
Yep.
You can buy claymores.
You can have like six great swords if you want to right now.
Oh, man. That is something I
Just switch them
want.
out.
But I'll have to come back because I don't have the souls for six great swords. But maybe someday.
Well, maybe someday, yeah.
Ooh, I see a soul. Or a thing. Okay, let's get out of here because I know the, like, phantoms here are kind of. Ooh.
So the brain thing in that I was
Okay,
referring to
that's.
in Bloodborne is called the Brain of Mensis.
Okay, Brain of Mensis, gotcha.
Yep.
Gotcha.
Which, by the way, anybody who knows like basically Cthulhu Mythos and or H.P. Lovecraft stuff,
Right.
that is just a straight up Sheogorath. So,
Okay, cool. See,
yep.
that's the interesting thing about Bloodborne for me is like I only know of like Lovecraft stuff kind of in passing. Like I didn't know it that
Sure.
well, but like Bloodborne was just like, oh my god, like this is really interesting to me now. I really should look into it. I haven't got around to doing that, but like I was like, oh damn, this is like Bloodborne was really good. I was
Yeah.
really deep into its lore. I really like it.
I agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, my roommates are huge into Lovecraft.
Oh, really? So they'd be really
Like,
into Bloodborne
majorly
then.
into it. Yeah, they're at least into the lore. Kenny still gets angry at the game because it's his first time playing any sort of like
Oh,
Souls-style game.
yeah.
So he's like, I'm not gonna go back to this, but I'm interested.
I see, I see.
So I'm like, hey, you give it a try. That's all I ever ask of
Oh,
anybody.
yeah. No, for sure. Like, the thing is, you know, give it a shot. It might be something you really get into.
Yeah.
And I think, like, when it comes to, like, the Souls series, Bloodborne's a pretty good entry point. Like, I mean, it's different, but, like, so many of the skills that you learn in the game are transferable. And
Yeah.
it's, yeah, it's like, my close friend, High Roller, like, they had no interest in Souls before Bloodborne, and they played, but they were really into, like, Bloodborne. They played Bloodborne, they loved it, and I was like, you should totally try, like, Dark Souls. You'll probably really like it. Because, of course, after Bloodborne, they were like, I want something like. I want, like, Bloodborne 2, and, like, play Dark Souls. It's really good. And they're like. And they were like, but I don't really have an interest in, like, sort of the medieval, you know, qualities of it. And, like, I think you'll like it
Sure.
anyways. And he was like over the moon with Dark Souls 2. He loved the game. So I was really pleased about that. Yeah. And it's one of those things too, like he's pretty like picky with his games, so it was, you know, nice that it was kind of a good hit for him.
Well, that's good then. I mean, yeah,
Yeah.
if he's picking with his games, and
Yeah.
I think like you're saying with recommending Dark Souls versus Bloodborne. Like, I think
Yeah.
it's if you play Bloodborne, you will
Yeah.
like Dark Souls enough. Like, there's a
Yeah.
little bit of a difference in the way it handles, but
Yeah.
not by too much.
No, for sure. It's one of those things, the only thing I wish was that, although, like, I do think it was, like, a smart move on Sony's part, like, you know, putting the money out for Bloodborne. I do kind of wish it was multi-platform, just because I have a lot of friends that I know don't have PS4, and I'm like, oh, you need to play Bloodborne.
Oh
Yeah.
yeah, I hear
Yeah.
you. That is the one good thing with living with people who have PS4, get to play it.
Yeah,
So,
gotcha. Yeah, that worked out
or
perfect.
like the fact that Greg got to play it because I own a PS. Well, I by virtue own a PS4.
Yeah, gotcha. I see. It kind of
Yeah.
worked out then.
Yeah.
Ooh. But yeah, nothing
Oh,
wrong
the.
with that. It's good too because like Bloodborne, like it's not a super long game, so it's, you know, something even if you don't have a PS4, you could probably sit down and play through it, you know, on someone else's PS4 in like just a
Oh,
couple
absolutely,
sittings.
yeah.
Yeah.
It's pretty short.
Yeah.
It feels good too, so like,
Yeah.
even though it is short,
Yeah.
it feels like a very robust game.
It's
Just
fleshed
a
out
lot of
well.
it.
Yeah. Like it's a good example of like how you can have a game that You know, you can have a shorter game, but still have it be really, like, thick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, so good. Hey, Tokyo. Welcome to the chat. It's been a while. Oh, I'm doing good. Yeah, I don't know. And that's the thing with Hyrule. I don't know if they're playing through Dark Souls 1, but I don't think they're in the right mindset to play Dark Souls 1 right now, because they're like playing it through to beat it before Dark Souls 3. So like,
that is actually the worst mindset to have going into that game, because there's a lot of it.
Yeah, exactly. And it's one of those things that like a very like his approach has been mostly been like focused on like running through areas. And it's like, no, you gotta savor it. You gotta savor it. But I have to admit, for like his like first time playing through Dark Souls 1, doing amazingly well. Like, he is just like taking down bosses left and right. He ran through like his like first attempt in Sen's fortress. He ran through like 90% of the fortress and then like died at the very end right before the bonfire. And I was like, "Whoa! Nobody freaking does that. That's crazy!" Like,
no,
all the traps are like going off behind him, and all the enemies are like getting hit by the traps that are going off as he's running by them. And I'm like, I can't believe this. Like, this area took me like several streams, and he did it like in less than like an hour and a half. It's just like, I can't believe this.
That's amazing.
So funny.
I mean, like, Sen's Fortress, I think, took everybody like a good, like, you know, 5 hours to get through that. Oh. Just to think about getting through that.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, there's skinny platforms, there's snake lady shooting lightning at me, there's a guy with a giant sword, there's giants at the top. What the hell is this thing?
There's so much going on in that area.
Yeah, it's true. It's true.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, another big discovery I just found out about the Bloodborne. You know the guys that the big hunchbacks, the bricks, and then like old yarn, like the new Yharnam, basically.
Yeah.
They're called brick trolls.
I knew that, but I don't know anything else. I don't like I remember that fact coming up, and I remember laughing at it. I'm like, the brick trolls. That's silly. And it never came up again, so... Is there any, like... I have no idea. I guess it's
There's a bit of lore for them, actually. Just like a little, like, guide description.
Oh, really?
Despite their low mental capacity, when agitated, they can deal with devastating blows. Like, obviously.
Yeah. Most definitely. Thanks, like, oh, my goodness. Like, when they hit you, it is, like, you reel from that. That really hurts.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm gonna see if I can do something here that I did last cycle, which kind of worked out. This was sort of, I guess, how I cheated the system last time.
You cheated the system, did you? Okay.
Sort of. Let me see if I can figure this out. I did something really weird, and it worked out. I think it was like right here, maybe.
All right. I like doing weird things.
Yeah, and I jump down here, and... Oh, whoa, I don't remember this guy. But I end up, fighting, what's-his-face's body early, because I skipped a spot where I would have had to have spent some branches.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So I think this is it, maybe. I might be wrong. Mm. Because I know in the first Dark Souls 2, he was in a different spot. So, I think he's down here. No, never mind, there is a branch here I have to use. I don't remember.
Yeah, the first version of Dark Souls, or Dark Souls 2. I keep going with that.
Yeah.
So, in the first version of Dark Souls 2, he's after the Duke's Dear Freya.
Right.
The giant spider boss.
Yeah.
Like, immediately after, in the Primal Bonfire location, he's there for some reason, and it's not clear why. Just... He, like, wandered into there without a head, and, like, the giant spider went, like, nah, it's cool you're here. I don't really care.
Whatever.
Whatever, headless Finn girl.
Yeah, exactly. he's just doing his thing. Actually, I better feather out of here, because this is... Like, you're supposed to come from the other direction, so I just, like... If I have had a branch, I could have fought him, but...
You went the direction I always go in this version of the game, so...
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
Fair
Yeah.
enough, it works. I didn't remember there being a. Actually, did I get any branches yet? I feel like this place should be littered with branches, but I don't think I've gotten any. No, I don't. Oh well, whatever. Branches will happen sooner or later, I'm sure. I'm not in any big
That's
rush.
true.
I can fight
I mean,
Scorpion Lady. That can be a thing.
you could make a rush to go fight, or at least get to the Iron Keep, because the shopkeeper there in the Iron Keep does actually sell branches of yore.
Oh, that's a good idea. That could
Yeah,
be a
so you
thing.
could actually go and do the Rotunda stuff and get
Right.
past like the Skeleton Lords
Right.
and just bolt right to there.
I'm trying to like
That is an option.
that could be a thing. That could be a thing. I'm trying to piece together in my mind like the gist of like all the routes. I'm like, 'cause I can totally picture where the Skeleton Lords are, but I can't picture how to get there. I think it's off of
You know where the high tower of flame is, where they go and get the lady to push the button for you?
right. It's other path
Yes,
there.
through there.
Yeah,
Yeah.
right. Because I think it came up like in the first stream. Because I think you're watching and you're like, "Have you done the Coliseum yet?" And I was like, "Coliseum? I don't know of this. I don't think I've encountered any
No.
Coliseums." Yeah, because that
No,
would have
but
been
yeah. Oh, yeah, right, yeah.
yeah, so easy to overlook because it's like, I already went down through there at one point. I already went down one direction. Wasn't thinking about the fact that that was actually a forked path. Yeah.
Yeah, basically if you go and do the Rotunda stuff now, like just pay 1,000 souls, get Alicia to turn the
Yeah.
Rotunda. And now just go over to the like the Iron Keep's area and just get through there, and then you
Gotcha.
buy a branch of yore and
That could be a
mosey
thing.
on. It also gets you like three to four bosses actually killed in that one area too.
Yeah, exactly. Iron Keep's a pretty good area there. And I think one of them at least. I think it's the Smelter Demon. I believe
Yep.
that's a Lugatiel fight, so that would also be
There
good.
is a Lugatiel fight,
Yeah.
that's true.
Yeah. So I kind of that's definitely like on the checklist of things to do for sure.
Actually, the Smelter Demon fight is where she's very, very, very useful.
Yeah, I can totally see that.
Because she just keeps her shield up the entire time. She doesn't really stagger very easily, so. And
Ooh.
she's like, well, I'm just going to block this guy, so if you want to just hit him in the butt, you can just
Yeah.
butt hit him.
And that you can just punch him in the butt.
Punch his butt. Just
Yeah,
punch his butt off.
Lugatiel's just like, I know you're an expert at that. Whoa. Oh, jeez. Might be.
I've seen your butt punching skills.
They're
They're the
they've been
curse.
foretold. They're of legend.
You're where the stars of the butt punch ya.
Oh, thank you, Tokyo. Was it? Yeah, no, my butt punching is unmatched. Maybe.
Oh, probably.
You're like, yes, most definitely.
Code is the best at punching butts. I've seen him punch a butt so hard it flew into hell.
Yeah.
So,
Launch that
yeah,
person up
straight
the
into hell.
ladder.
Yep.
Okay.
Straight into hell.
It took me forever to get up to
Oh.
that Covenant. I forget what his name is. Dark Diver.
Dark, yeah,
Yeah.
crippled Gandalf, basically, what I call
Yeah.
him.
That works. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see.
It's
He
like
gets around.
Grandval,
He
though, so it's
gets
close.
around. You know.
He does, somehow. He's
Yeah.
kind of like the end, I find, in like Metal Gear Solid 3.
He kinda
When you
is.
shoot at him.
Yeah. Oh
When you
god, that
shoot
is
at him
such a
when he's
good
in the
fight.
wheelchair, he just like squeals away.
Swells away. Oh my god, that is one of my favorite fights. That is one of my favorite fights.
Yeah,
Like,
the end is amazing.
end
Yeah.
is an excellent fight. And I love the fact that it's like layered. Like there's so many, like you can take him out before the fight and you just don't do that fight. Or you can or there's even the trick where it's like you let leave your you change your PS2 clock and
Yep.
he'll die of old
It's
age. And
amazing.
it's like
Just dies of old age.
like that is incredible. There's so good. God
You
damn
shoot
it.
his parrot and he gets really mad at you.
Yeah, if you shoot, yeah, if you eat his parrot, it's even worse. don't eat
He's
parrot.
like, ah!
Oh, he's so angry about that. He's like, why would you do that?
No!
What the hell's wrong with you?
Crackers.
Oh, jeez. Oh, no.
It's kind of cool if you, like, killed, if you can kill the end, and you can get that parrot as, like, just a pet the entire way through the game.
That'd be...
They're pretty great.
That'd be pretty great.
I'd into that.
It'd be great if it could, like, help you. It's just, like, mm-hmm, just improves you, improves your sniping. But you get the, whatchamacallit, from that. So, you know.
Isn't it the tranquilizer rifle?
Yeah, it's a tranquilizer rifle. I can't think of the name of it. It's like the Mossen something. But no, it's a good weapon.
Yeah.
Metal Gear Solid 3 is so good. It's been a while since I've played it. Have you played,
Yeah, Metal Gear Solid is great.
Have you played, Phantom Pain?
No.
Okay.
I've gotten into a weird thing where, like, I got so bummed out by Konami that I just couldn't be prepared to, like, play that game.
No, that is completely
Even though I want to play it, it looks really, really, really good.
It's
such a sad thing.
I will tell you this right now. I feel really mixed on the game.
Yeah,
it fell into a weird spot for me personally.
Sure.
Did you play Peace Walker?
I played enough Peace Walker. I didn't play the entire thing, but I played a good portion of it.
Okay. In my opinion, it does just about what Peace Walker does, but kind of, I guess what you compare it to, I can't really say from experience, but you compare it to, like, Far Cry. Like, going around, blowing up outposts and stuff like that, you know.
I really enjoyed Far Cry 3, but, like, I hear you. Like, that's kind of not what I want from Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah. I feel like, personally, I liked how Peace Walker handled things, like, far more. Phantom Pain, like, it does some really good things, but I will say at a certain point you can tell when Kojima left. Like, there is a really...
Mm.
firm, like, mark in the sand when he left.
Yeah. I can kind of see where that is. Just from watching it being streamed and that kind of thing.
Okay, you've watched some
streams. I
can kind
of tell.
Then. Yeah, okay, gotcha.
Yeah, I watched enough of that game being played. I'm like, I'm not going to play it, but I might as well, you know, support a YouTuber and, you know, watch them play or whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
And, yeah, Phantom Pain, I don't know, it's such a weird thing where, like, I can tell where that scene is, where, like, you know, Kojima wanted to make this robust kind of open world Metal Gear Solid, but there are plenty of times where there's a lot of forced mechanics in there.
Yeah, there's definitely, like, a spot. I don't want to get into it too far, because I know there's people in the chat that probably haven't played through it, but I will say, there's a certain point where it starts to really loop heavily on its content, like, you're doing missions over again, which is just a harder version of X Mission, or the sometimes it isn't even that the mission's harder, it's just that the requirements are tighter. It's like, if the requirements in the first time mission was to, you know, beat it with, you know, out killing two guards, you know, beat it with less than two kills, the hard version might be beat it with no kills, and it's like, well, I did that the first time.
Yeah, no, I understand that. That's something I'm having a problem with the majority of those games at this point.
Yeah,
like, anything that's open world is just, it feels now like they've taken a very MMO kind of stance where it's like, okay, great, we need you to do the exact same
thing.
Task, exactly the same mission.
That's a really good way to
put
it,
but, like, just a little bit different.
Yeah, it's a really good way to put it, because. Yeah, that is exactly what it's like. It's very MMO-esque, where it's like, you know, go kill five mushrooms. And in this case, it's, you know, go, you know, CQC five guards.
Yeah. My again, co-host and friend Kenny, actually, he has the best term for it, and that's collecting wolf noses.
Collecting wolf noses? Interesting.
Yes.
It's an interesting term for
it. Yeah, so whenever... I really like that one. This is just a dumb kind of, like, why would you need a wolf nose?
I'm putting that on my list of things that, like, terms, and I actually do have a list, like, a mental list of this. My good friend Keed, who sometimes like is on mic with me,
Sure.
Collectathons. He loves like new games, old games. So he, you know, has a big collection of games. But like collectathon games, like Mario 64. Not so much Mario 64, but a better example is like Donkey Kong 64. I don't know if you're familiar with
like
it,
your,
but
Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah, it's like really collectible heavy. His term for Donkey Kong 64 is monkey go find things.
Monkey go find things. I love it.
It's so perfect because it totally describes what that game is like.
It really does. He's right.
It's really good. But yeah, no. Collecting wolf noses. Well, there you go. That's a great term for it. But no, as far as Phantom Pain goes, I feel like it starts out, it's interesting, but it really wanes towards like the later half of the game, unfortunately.
Looks pretty front-loaded with good stuff.
Yeah.
And then, like, I like the way it looks, how it plays, like how it animates and how everything kind of seems.
Yeah.
And
there's like
a lot of the mechanics look pretty good.
There's a lot of smart choices in it. Like a lot of like they really like changed up the way like they score missions. So like you, it's more freeform now. So like if you want to go guns blazing, you can do that. If you want to go full stealth, you can do that, and it will reward you kind of appropriate in both directions. So it's not just kind of focused on one particular play style, which is nice because that's been of course a common complaint with Metal Gear. I like doing the stealth thing, and it's like, well, it's meant to be a stealth game, but, like, I can understand, a running issue's been, I guess, it's like in Metal Gear Solid 3, you get really cool guns sometimes, and it's like, I have no use for this, because it makes noise, and it kills.
It's true.
And it's like, I don't want to do either
Wait
of those
a second,
things.
Dude. Well, it's using the boss, basically.
Yeah, exactly.
There you go. I actually full-on blame, Splinter Cell Conviction for that.
Okay.
Because that was the fifth Splinter Cell game.
Okay.
Which you can tell because it has a V in the word Conviction.
Okay, gotcha.
That's how they marketed that. Basically, when they put that game out, they're like, well, now Sam Fisher's like more of a big, brutish, tough guy because he lost his daughter and now there's these problems. He's like basically like Liam Neeson from Taken now.
Okay.
It's like, okay, that's all right.
Yeah.
Alright, cool.
Yeah.
And then it's like, well, you can run in guns a-blazin', and that's fine.
Yeah.
But then, like, stealth is still the main reason I play these games.
Right, so, you know, you want
like,
strong...
Like, I love stealth action.
Uh-oh. That's not good. I just had to pick a fight with the Scorpion Queen here, and... Oh, jeez. I'm having minor regrets.
She's kinda wrecking ya.
Yeah. She was really easy my first playthrough, so... Like, whoa! Okay, don't want no part of that. Actually, I saw a wonderful...
Yeah, I actually do find she's far harder in New Game Plus.
You know what I need to do? I need to take my lock-on off, maybe.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm locking onto her front half, and it's like... I don't necessarily want to be fighting her front half. I don't know if I sent you, like, a gif of this, but there's a wonderful glitch where somebody, damn, I ate that pretty bad. Where she does the thing where she sticks her tails in the ground, and like somebody gets hit on the way when they're being pulled up, and it like launches them like 300 feet in the air.
Jeez.
And then they die via falling, which is incredible. Yeah, she's not taking much damage.
No, she's pretty tanky.
Yeah, she's pretty tanky in this. It's good though.
My strategy for her is actually to stay like near just the back to the right or the left.
Gotcha.
So when she actually does that spin with her tail, it just wraps around you, you not get hit at all.
Gotcha. I see. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Though it's also hard to do because she will turn around and try and stab you with her spear thingy or whatever.
Yeah. I think this is under control for the most part, maybe.
Yeah. You got it.
Yeah. It's looking good here. You know what? I don't know if I ever got the item that's in that tree.
It's just some spice, basically.
Okay.
So don't worry about it.
Crap, I lost track of
that's,
her.
That's the problem. Everybody's like, oh, I need to get that item. And it's like, no, you actually don't. It's actually garbage.
One more.
And yes,
One
Steve,
more
I
swim.
agree. Those taken movies fill my brain.
Melt your brain. No,
straight up, like,
poor Steve.
Take it one. Pretty good movie. Mm-hmm. Pretty cool premise. You know, his daughter gets taken and this kind of thing. He's got to go get her back and
right.
He's got some specific skills. Taken two.
Yeah.
His like ex-wife gets taken now.
Right.
And then in Taken 3, his daughter gets taken again.
He's like, how does this
so
keep
Liam
happening?
Yeah, so, like, Liam Neeson's a bad parent is what the movie is.
Yeah.
Like, that's just what it boils down to. And it's like, well, you should probably get your life under control. Stop, like, angering bad guys, Liam Neeson.
Yeah, really. Jeez. Like, you know, how's it go, you know. Shit. You know,
I have
really,
a very
really after,
set of skills.
After the second time, really, it's, you know, shame on you.
Yeah, it really is.
Oh, God.
No, yeah, fool me once, shame on me. Yeah. Fool me twice. Well.
Yeah, I saw the first one, but it was a while ago.
No,
I've never seen any of the other ones, so I had no idea that they're. Honestly, I didn't even know there was a third one, so.
Oh, man, they got ripened.
Oh.
I have no idea why, because the first one's, like, good enough.
Yeah.
Like, if you want to watch the second and third one, just watch the first one again, and that's
oh,
all you need to do.
Okay, it's, like, the same.
It's, like, the exact same movie with some differences.
Okay.
Not a lot, either.
I see. Well, that definitely happens. Mm. Actually, I did a thing, which... Okay, I think I'm okay. I was about to say, I didn't check to see if there was any summon signs for, Ben Hart or, Lucatiel. Before the scorpion.
Oh.
Yeah, but there wasn't.
Yeah, I didn't think so either.
I don't think there is, so. Let's level up! Put one point into one thing!
Yay! Oh man, a point!
Wow.
Where are you gonna put that point, Code?
I don't know. Maybe
I
should...
Let's put it in resistance.
Let's put it in resistance. Exactly.
Or adaptability, I should say.
Yeah, that's totally what I'm gonna put it in. Let's do that.
Good plan. Let's do that.
Why not, right? You know, something I'm a